other people. You have to get involved. I recall when Amaya walked into my office, she had this beautiful spirit and she had this smile on her face and she looked so vulnerable. And her aunt looked me in the eye and she said, "Help her. Help her. She needs someone to guide her." She said, "I heard about you at your event. I was there. I want you to be able to help her." And I remember thinking, she has so many barriers and so many obstacles. She was pregnant with her second child. She didn't have housing. She had a record. Her job was unstable. And here she was, 4 months pregnant. And there was an expectation that things would change overnight. And the first thing that I told her was, you have to be prepared to help yourself.
So my aunt introduced me to Miss Rosemary because I needed some help at the time. And she felt that Miss Rosemary would be a good advocate to help me. 19, and I was like grasping for straws. I didn't really know what my next steps were or what was my plan from where I was then. And I was just taking whatever help I could get. And I was working here at Taco Bell for as long as I could because I was pregnant. Yep, I was working and I just needed a little extra help, whatever like I couldn't find or whatever I needed help with Miss Rosemary, just, you know, took it step by step, broke it down. We came up with goals, we wrote things down, we researched things together, and we had meetings almost like every week.
I can help you, but you have to be prepared to help yourself. 6 months later, she has her record expunged. She will be moving into her first apartment. She started going to the doctor and she had a healthy pregnancy and delivery. She built out her network and started to build friends and close personal relationships. I'm so glad that she was the first person that I physically helped one-on-one in our program. And I recall calling her weekly and texting her weekly saying, "Did you do what you said you would do?" Accountability is number one in this program. Learning to problem solve, being accountable, looking at your goals and your future. Knowing that these young people and their families are depending on me to help them change their lives.
Working, I'm on maternity leave, but my job is like guaranteed when I come back, so that's that. And, as far as my apartment, I'll be moving in within like 2 weeks or something like that. And like, baby's healthy. I'm doing really good now. We're gonna start working on my temps. I wanna start working on my temps so that I can be driving soon. Cause it's really hard with like the buses and stuff, keeping up with transportation,
always having like bus fare. Just the buses, period. Like the distance that you have to go on the buses and how many of them, and doing it every day can be exhausting. So, I'm gonna be looking into like a daycare type deal for my daughter, and from then I'm gonna be finding a job that's convenient to where we live now. So it's definitely in the plan.
I would honestly just say like, your kids they're here for you, and you know you have to do whatever you can and whatever you have to for your kids, because at the end of the day, I mean, they need you, and no one else is gonna, you know, do it. You gotta do what you gotta do, and just keep your head up about it. Like, I'm 19, and I mean, I had my GED and stuff, and I was in hair school when I got pregnant with my first child, Blake. And I had things, you know, started on a good track, but I didn't have, like, the best support team. So, if you do or if you don't, the main thing is just keep your head up and, you know, focus on what you have to do and get everything accomplished. Just don't give up, like, no matter how hard it gets. There's always someone out there, even if it's not Miss Rosemary or, you know, like Hamilton County or whatever. There's someone out there that'll help you, that'll, you know, listen to you or be there for you, and just keep pushing.